Hey everyone. So I addressed it partially in a live stream, but I want to address it in full and talk about it a little bit more. But everyone wants to talk about Brian Michael Bendis leaving Marvel and heading to DC. And can you blame them? I mean, Bendis, as far as I'm aware, has only ever written one book for DC in the past, but has been a veteran player for Marvel for a very long time. He wrote, basically everybody at this point. And gave them one of their new flagship characters, Miles Morales. Ultimately, what's my opinion on Bendis? I think he's a good writer when he's inspired. When there's not somebody over his shoulder, you know, like editorial, screaming and telling him to do X, Y, and Z. And, you know, a lot of this SJW stuff that's happening at Marvel is originating from editorial. And Bendis is one of those people who I've suspected for a long time is not on board with the SJW train. When he does it, it's really awkward. It's really forced. To speak to one example specifically, with Riri Williams, every time the SJW stuff comes up, it's really awkwardly handled. I mean, the psychopath, blackmailing, emotional extortion, please discriminate against me BS that happened with Riri and the school teacher is, you know, just one example of where it felt so damn forced that it did not seem like it came from Bendis. We know Bendis knows how to write characters like Jessica Jones and Luke Cage. And then we see what he does with them in other books. And it just feels like he's doing what he's told. I suspect this thing that's been going on with Bendis has been brewing for quite a while, but there's a couple of points that I think are really worth addressing in full. And again, of where I think this all started from what I've heard and from what I've seen. Apparently, Bendis was not very happy about the shift with what's happening with the movies. Because he did write a small segment for the end of Iron Man 1, the scene where Nick Fury first confronts Tony Stark. I believe that was written by Brian Michael Bendis. And he was kind of used as a consultant or something. That's a rumor, but there's never been anything that officially stated he was used as a consultant for the movies. But there's also some stuff that's come out now that Bendis was very unhappy with how the whole diversity doesn't sell thing happened, and that there were so many attempts to re-clarify what was meant by that because Bendis kept pushing so hard. You know, one of the things I heard is that he didn't like how it basically painted the fans as racist, blah, 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 blah. So, you know, but there's not a lot of information on that. Another point that was brought up was that there was the Writers Summit before New York Comic Con, where all the writers are supposed to get together, talk about stories, brainstorm things. And, this was confirmed a long time ago. But a lot of the time was spent talking about us YouTubers, about us trolls and harassers, and that Dan Slott and a couple of other people kept really pushing this to the point where nobody could even get any work done because they were so there were a couple of people were so obsessed with Twitter drama and YouTube drama that the Writers Summit was effectively worthless. Bendis had also really been overworked at Marvel. At one point, he was working on 7 friggin' books. And even now, I think he's, at his lower point, not too long ago, was working on 5. I think he's down to 4 right now. But it really seems that he has been overworked, been tired with what's been going on, was told effectively, you have to write Riri Williams. You can't write Tony Stark. And was told to come up with Riri Williams and what was happening with that and make that character. Knowing how Bendis is and how he likes to write for characters that he knows and specifically has recreated, in a sense, I don't really think he would have liked to just drop Tony Stark, considering he seemed to have had a lot he was building up to with Tony, and then just shift force over to Riri, which was an editorial idea that did not come from Bendis. There were also the problems that he had apparently with Secret Empire. He was not a fan of it. He didn't want any of his books to cross over with it. He didn't want to write for it. He stayed very much far away from it and wanted his characters that he was working on to stay out of it, but he didn't really have a say in that. There's also the fact that there was a bit of a debacle with Infamous Iron Man. When he was first, you know, talking about Infamous Iron Man and the idea he had, he was talking about how he wanted the ultimate Reed Richards to be the main villain. He was really excited about that idea, and he was even saying in an interview it was the most inspired he's felt for a very long time, and it was kind of this rebirth of you know, his enthusiasm for the craft. Was this series and this idea? And Infamous Iron Man was originally supposed to be a 9-page miniseries, and that's all it was. And he had a set idea in his head that Reed Richards was supposed to be the main villain, which is probably why he set up so much with Ben Grimm as the sort of antagonist in the secondary antagonist, protagonist, both sides being played by Ben, in this story. And even the Johnny Storm portion that was in there, which was amazingly well done. I loved that part of the story. But you could even, you know, he started getting lazy after he was told, no, it's going to be 12 issues. No, it's going to be Mephisto, not Reed Richards. And I suspect that was something that came from editorial. Given the enthusiasm that he showed for evil Reed Richards initially, it seems very odd that he would then, in the last issue, without really building to it all that much, just poof, here's Mephisto. So I think this is something that has been brewing for quite some time. And, you know, now that Marvel's not doing all that well, there's a lot of comic pros who are very concerned, you know, that at the end of the fiscal year is coming up and those numbers are going to be seen about just how much they are falling in terms of sales and revenue. That maybe he was seeing, you know, thinking that he was going to be getting a drop in pay and, you know, maybe even laid off in favor of new talent, really big air quotes around talent on that one, around new talent that would be paid less because they have no experience versus Bendis, who's a 20 plus year veteran for Marvel Comics. Now, say what you will about him, but I mean, you got to admit, the guy swings out with some pretty good books. He's going to be leaving a huge void in Marvel right now because they're going to be losing another A-lister. You know, are they possibly going to promote from within, send one of these new writers up to his position, or take somebody with more experience? I've heard people say that they hope Jason Aaron takes that slot, or Jeff Lemire. Honestly, I think they're probably just going to take the books he was working on and, you know, ship them around. They're not going to take the exact workload that was being done by Bendis and switch it off all to one person. But, I mean, it does kind of raise concerns. What's going to happen to Miles Morales? I was actually enjoying Miles's series and was really excited by this idea of Miles wanting his own identity and becoming his own hero. You know, and it also makes me wonder who the hell is going to get put on Iron Man. That's the one that really concerns me the most, is what garbage are we going to see happen with Riri Williams and Tony Stark now that Bendis is gone? Because at least he seemed to be... No, he wasn't trying, I'm sorry. I can't say that with a straight face. But as far as his move to DC goes, he's apparently going to have a bit of a hand in the movies, which I think would be a good thing, getting somebody who actually knows comics and is a comics fan in there alongside Geoff Johns to help make these movies better at DC. But as far as what characters I'd want to see him write, I would love to see Bendis take on Static Shock and bring back Static Shock to the DC universe. I know a lot of people have been wanting that lately. Or even, you know, suggestions were thrown around like, Batwing, Booster Gold, Blue Beetle. But my thing is I really want to see him writing Static Shock. I think that would be something that's very much up his alley, and it would play to his strengths, really. Or even a Harvey Bullock miniseries, I think, would be pretty cool. It's been a while since I've read Batman lately. I have been picking up Batman, so I honestly don't know the situation with that. I could be, completely off. But if he's still around. But even then, you could do a prequel, you could do something, but I think that'd be a good spot for him. A Harvey Bullock miniseries, an 8-parter, and then, once writers are cleared up, maybe put him on a few more books. But ultimately, I'm going to be very enthusiastic about this. It'll be good to see what Bendis does now that editorial won't be breathing over his shoulder like a fucking vulture. Because I said it once, I'll say it again. This SJW crap really seems to be coming from the new writers and editorial. And that's why I think a lot of the, longtime writers, with the exception of Dan Slott, are not really that big into this identity politics crap. Partly because it does seem forced by so many of them. But that's my thoughts. What are yours? Let me know down in the comments section below. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe and do all that good jazz. And don't forget to punch the shit out of that bell. And so make sure you get the notifications. And till next time, guys, have fun.